encourage people to the activities that we've gone up to thus far. I'd like to place on record the support, the huge support that I've received from Mr. Chairman and all the members. And I think that I would be ungrateful if on a day like this I did not put on record. I just thought I should use this opportunity to thank you so very much. And looking forward to greater support and collaboration in the months and years ahead. For this presentation today, Your Excellency, let me say that on behalf of all us and then of the defense sectors, I most sincerely express our gratitude to this Business Committee and indeed the Ninth National Assembly for the efficient support provided to the defense sectors in the past years. Your support has greatly assisted the defense sectors to contribute immensely to making Nigeria more secure. As you know, the defense sector has the constitutional mandate of coordinating the activities of the armed forces of Nigeria. And to achieve this, the defense sector formulates and implements policies and programs towards the attainment of national security and operational competence of the Air Force of Nigeria. And the annual budget defends, which of course is the platform that affords the ministry's budget and agents the opportunity to increase their budget performance in the first year, as well as defend their proposals for the coming year. And so for ROS defense sectors in the year 2021, percentage performance of the defense sector budget for the personnel monument as of September 2021 was 75%. The overhead was 59%, while capital was 96%. In view of these, I make bold to state that the performance of the defense sector 2021 budget has been significantly impressive. The defense sector in its year, perhaps, defense sector in its year 22 budget requested for the sum of 89.4 billion naira only. The details of this request are contained in the defense sector year 2022 budget defense booklet, which was earlier submitted to this distinguished committee. However, the Federal Ministry of Finance, Budget and National Planning appropriated the total sum of 68 billion naira only. This reduction would impinge on the capacity and tempo of the defense sector in carrying out its mandates and responsibilities and clearly in the various internal security operations across the length and breadth of the country. Therefore, I wish to passionately appeal to this distinguished Senate Committee on Defense to assist the defense sector to increase its 2022 overhead, capital, and personnel budget proposals to what we had earlier submitted, which is 89.4 billion naira only. Perhaps at this stage, I'd like to pray that that defense capital 2022 overhead budget be increased from 1.5 billion naira to 4.3 billion naira. Two, defense sector 2022 personnel monument budget be increased to 71.9 billion naira only. And three, the capital budget proposals of 13.1 billion naira only be approved for our capital projects. In concluding this brief, let me restate that defense sector is committed to carrying out its constitutional mandate of coordinating the activities of the armed forces, as well as conducting internal security operations across Nigeria. I am optimistic that timely and full implementation of the year 2022 budget